here at the Courier Museum in beautiful Manchester. Well, she's like a seven, Manchester. Some people call her Manch Vegas, or the same assholes who say Tarjay instead of Target. Don't do that. It's Manchester, New Hampshire. For some kind of New Hampshire media makers meetup, and I happen to be one of those. So I thought I should come. Kick some ass and take some names and chew some bubblegum. But as it happens, I'm out of bubblegum as well. As well as self-respect. I don't know what I'm walking under right now. It's red. Oh, come on, let me take a picture with you. Come on, don't be vain. I got this same piece from IKEA. It was hell putting together. This guy here is about to give Bugs Bunny a really hard time. Computer lady, what will she teach us today? Hey, I'm on top of a mountain.
Hold it. Yeah, what if I've written all I can?
Healthy nerves, good red blood, strong teeth and bones. The oat cereal that needs no cooking.
He's feeling his cheery.
So last night I had this dream that a bunch of my coworkers were in a plane crash. But it's okay, like everybody survived the plane crash, and also the plane crash happened right outside our office building, because it was a dream. So we all ran out to greet the survivors, and everybody was hugging and everything because emotions were running high, but also because emotions were running high, everybody was, like, speaking the truth. So a bunch of people started hugging me and saying to me, "I've never liked you." So to recap, last night I had a dream where a bunch of people in rapid succession hugged me and told me they didn't like me.
Do you ever think that you have, like, a really good idea early in the morning, and then when you're actually out of bed and moving around and stuff, you can't remember it? Think about how much worse that feels for Kanye West.
Hey, do you guys think that back when Conor Oberst was dating Winona Ryder, sometimes they, like, woke up in the morning and had to look at each other for a second and figure out who was who?
The new luxury length for a taste that challenges comparison.
Firm and trim and handsome, so easy to take. I'm today's new Curio.
I'm here to die. Why don't you pick me up and smoke me sometime?
Okay, Daddy. It's so easy to make a cake with Betty Crocker cake mix. I'll make her another one.
What's the point of even sleeping?
Series of narrow streets and buildings pretty much built inside of each other. What are you supposed to do with record snowfall? I'll tell you what. Welcome to Pierce Island. Pierce Island is where the city of Portsmouth dumps all of their snow. And it's still here. It's 70 degrees today. Look at it. It looks like a Star Wars. Jory is in Toronto right now, and so Christy had this idea that wouldn't it be funny if we covered Jory's whole apartment with party streamers? So that's what we're gonna do.
No one could tell from time to time with a plan to change.
Oh, 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 if a plan to change.
Kia Sportage sounds like a topical rash. They're like, oh, he's got a little bit of a Kia Sportage on his elbow.
For me, April is about self-improvement, and I mean like an achievable, small step kind of self-improvement, because like, there's a line where it's like you're being a reasonable person with your act together, and I'm like just below it. And the realization that I am here and not here came a couple weeks ago when we were bowling, and my bowling shoes, they were kind of tight, and I was kind of weird. That doesn't usually happen because I lie and pretend that I have bigger feet than I do. So the fact that they were tight along the front was kind of strange to me, and I thought, you know, I probably haven't cut my toenails in a while. I should probably do that. So at one point, I go in for the bowling, and, you know, I take the step, and something hurts, and I go, wow, that hurt. That wasn't good. But I play through, because I'm a professional. Not a professional bowler, but I mean, like, I'm just a professional person. And anyway, later that night, when I go home and I take my sock off, I go, oh, wow, there you go. My toenail broke, and, like, my foot's covered in blood. So that's fine, but then a couple days later, I'm walking around, and I'm still uncomfortable. And I was like, what is that? So I look at my feet, and I realize that the chunk of toenail that broke off my pinky toe, didn't look for it at the time, I just thought it was still in the sock or something, was actually embedded in my other toe right next to it. So I had to rip a big chunk of my toenail out of the side of my toe. And that was when I was like, you know, this can't happen again. So I've got this temporary crown in, and it popped out last night while I was watching the Taraji P. Henson episode of Saturday Night Live, and I know that a lot of people have said in the past, I would rather perform dental surgery on myself than listen to Mumford & Sons, but at least now, in the future, when I say that, I can back it up.
Soldiers come quickly.
Just got back from traveling, and Zach and Christy left me a little present.